So hey guys, I'm Vinay Parnegal and today we're going to talk about sampling online data. So let me take you through what this problem entails. We are supposed to write a program that takes as input a size k and reads packets, continuously maintaining a uniform random subset of size k of the read packets. So basically, remember the previous lecture where we were given a constant size n of whatever values, and we were to generate a subset, a uniform random subset of size k from these n numbers, n elements, right? So this is slightly the next step in that question, where we are not just exactly given a constant set of elements like of size n. We are given a continuously generated stream of here we call them packets, but it's just numbers, right? We are generating a continuous stream of packets, and every time we generate a packet, we have to recalculate this uniform random subset of size k, right? So we don't have any number as n in this situation, but anyway, as we were if we were to talk about the brute force approach in this situation, what we can do is every time we receive a new packet, say we have n packets already and we are supposed to calculate a subset of size k, and we've already done that, and now every time we receive a new packet, now we'll have n plus 1 packets, right? So then we have to run the entire algorithm from the previous lecture on that size n plus 1 and recalculate a subset of uniform random subset of size k, and then when we get the next packet, now our size n plus 2, and again we run the entire algorithm from the previous lecture and recalculate it. And do remember that the previous lecture's algorithm had a time complexity of big O of k, so we would have a time complexity of big O of n into k in this situation, because for every time a new packet is sent to us, every time we receive a new packet from the input stream, we are recalculating the entire we are running the entire algorithm all over again, which gives us a time complexity of big O of n into k. And since every time we receive a new packet, we have to store it somewhere in an array of sorts, because we need to use that array to run the algorithm from the previous lecture, we're essentially achieving a space complexity of big O of n. And initially it might seem like this is the best that we can do, but as we will see, the algorithm that we are going to talk about today is going to achieve it in faster time, and also is going to use lesser space than the brute force method that I just mentioned to you. So the logic over here is, let's say you're receiving a stream of elements, right? And we are supposed to calculate a uniform random subset of size k. Now, if let me talk to you about the situation which is not really applicable here. Like if the stream has generated only less than k number of elements, and we are supposed to calculate a subset of size k. Now this is not exactly possible, right? We have less than k elements, so we are not going to tackle that situation here. We are going to assume that we have at least k elements, or possibly more than that. And let me talk to you about the trivial situation where we have exactly k elements. The stream has given us exactly k elements. In that situation, there is it's a trivial situation where we don't need to calculate anything, because given k elements, and we are supposed to generate a subset of size k, we are just going to choose all of them, right? So that's another a situation where there's no calculation required. And after that, after having k elements, every element that we receive from the stream, we have to run this algorithm and perform it so that we can generate a uniform random subset of size k every time with good time and space complexity. So let me use this example. What we're going to do here is we are going to assume that we are receiving these elements in a stream, and we are going to start with a subset containing p and q. Our k is equal to 2 in this situation, and we are going to start with having received these two elements, and our subset obviously contains the the only two elements that we receive, which is P and Q. Now let's say we receive R, right? So now the if we are we have received three elements, and the probability of choosing R in the subset will be, obviously it will be 2/3, right? Using basic math, it would be 2/3. So we choose R to put into our subset with a probability of 2/3, right? Let's say R is not selected in that probability, so we don't change the subset and we just move on. Now we receive our fourth element, which is S, and the probability of choosing S in our subset of size 2 is obviously 2/4, because we've received four elements, right? So with a probability of 2/4, we can put S into our subset. Let's say we do put it. In that situation, we need to replace one of the elements in the subset that is already present with S, right? So we randomly choose one of these elements uniformly, and let's say Q has been chosen. So in that situation, we replace Q with S, right? And now we move on, we receive the fifth object from the stream, which is T, the fifth element, and T is selected to put into the subset with a probability of 2/5, and let's say it turns out that it is selected. In that situation, we have to find an element in the current subset which we replace with T, right? And let's say this time uniformly, randomly, we choose it and it turns out to be P, right? So we remove P and replace it with T, and we continue again, and we are given the element U from the stream, the sixth element, and now U is selected to put into the subset with a probability of 2/6, and let's say that it wasn't selected this time, so we don't change the subset and we leave the subset as it is. So essentially, for each every time we receive a new element from the stream, we don't exactly run the entire algorithm from the previous lecture, because that will give you a higher time complexity, a big O of nk, but instead we just calculate the probability of having that element in the subset, and then if we do select it, then we replace a current element in the subset with that. Now I'll take you through the code and explain how what I just told you about, how the logic behind the code is implemented in this in the code. So we have something called a string stream, which essentially gives you a stream of numbers, right? And we have initialized a vector of integer called running sample, which essentially stores your subset of selected elements, current subset of selected elements to be precise. And like I mentioned, if your stream has generated less than k elements, then there's no point, you can't do anything about it. So we are going to assume that the stream size is definitely less, more than k, at least k or more than k. So for I is equal to 0 and I less than k, as long as stream is generating elements, we add them or put them into the vector, right? And now this uses the same random number generator engine from C++ that we used in the previous lecture, and we generate a random number using this. And we have another variable called num seen so far, and at the moment we have seen exactly k elements, right? So we have initialized it to k. Now we run this loop, which is basically the crux of the code, and while we are still getting numbers from the stream, we increase num seen so far, because every time we get a new number, we have seen one more number, so we increase the value called num seen so far. And now this is the part where you choose whether that number that you just received is selected with a probability of so much and or not selected, right? So what we are doing over here is we are generating a random number between 0 and num seen so far, right? Essentially, we are selecting a random number between 0 and all the numbers that we have received until now. At least if you have received n, then the n numbers, then we are choosing a random number between 0 and n minus 1, right? And if that number is in 0 comma k minus 1, which means if that if the current number that we just received is this, if the number selected is between 0 and k minus 1, it is essentially it essentially means that we are going to replace one of the numbers in the subset with the number that we just received from the stream, right? And if it is the random number that we generated is between 0 and k minus 1, then replace it with the number we just got from the stream. And if it's not in between 0 comma k minus 1, if it's k or greater, k comma num seen so far minus 1, in that situation it's equivalent to saying that the number was not selected. The number that we just received was not selected. So what we're doing is exactly what we're doing here. We have a variable called id to replace, and we are generating a random number between 0, comma num seen so far minus 1, right? Any of the numbers that we have just received, right? And if the index, it's this 0, comma num seen so far is essentially pointing to the index of the number that we want to talk about. And if that index is between 0 and k minus 1, then we replace whichever index that we have just received with the number that we just got from the stream. Otherwise, we don't do any replacements, and we just let the subset be as is, right? If id dot replace is less than k, id to replace is less than k, which means that we are going to replace whatever number that we have generated through the uniform to the random number generator. We replace that the number at that index by the number that we just received from the stream. I want to repeat this once more so that it becomes very clear. We are using the random number generator to generate an index between 0 and num seen so far minus 1, right? We have seen say n numbers, so we generate a random index between 0 and n minus 1, right? And any of these indices can be generated with a probability of n by 1 by n, obviously, right? So the probability of generating an index between 0 comma k minus 1 is obviously k by n, right? Which essentially is the probability of choosing the number that we just received in the stream to be put into the subset, which was what we were doing in this example. When we got a new number, say s, then we said that the probability of s being selected was 2 by 4, which is k by n, right? That's exactly what we're doing here. We are using the random number generator to randomly select one index between 0 comma num seen so far minus 1, which is 0 comma n minus 1. So the probability of selecting any of the first k indices is k by n, right? So if this does turn out to be true, if the number generated is between 0 comma k minus 1, then we replace the value in that index by the number that we just received. And if it's not between 0 comma k minus 1, then it's essentially means that it's equivalent to not selecting the number that we just received in the stream and just continuing with your the next number that we are going to receive from the stream. This while loop runs until the stream is still giving us numbers. After stream stops giving us numbers, we can just return our vector called running sample. And you'll notice that we are going to run this loop one time for every number that we receive from the stream. Essentially, our time complexity is proportional to the number of elements in the stream. Since we don't exactly have a variable to represent that, we can't exactly say something like big O of n, but this will count to be a linear algorithm, linear running time. And our space complexity of big O of k, because our vector running sample is essentially the only extra space that we're going to use, and it is going to store k elements all the time. If we want to add a new element, we add and we delete some other element that is already present in the running sample, essentially exchanging in a way. So our space complexity is going to be big O of k, and our time complexity is going to be linear, proportional to the number of elements that we receive through the stream. And that essentially brings us to the end of this example. It did become a little detailed, but to stress the point, I found it better to repeat myself a couple of times. I hope you like it.